two households, both alike in dignity, in fair Verona where we lay our scene, from ancient grudge break to new mutiny, where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. From forth the fatal loins of these two foes, a pair of star-crossed lovers take their life, whose misadventured piteous overthrows do with their death bury their parents' strife.
Do you bite your thumb at us, sir?
No, sir. I do not bite my thumb at you, sir. But I bite my thumb, sir. Do you quarrel, sir?
Quarrel, sir? No, sir.
If you do, sir, I am for you. I serve as good a man as you.
No better.
Yes, sir. Better.
You lie!
Heart fools, put up your swords. You know not what you do.
What? Drawn in talk of peace? I hate the word as I hate hell. All Montagues and thee. Have at thee, coward!
Rebellious subjects, throw your mistempered weapons to the ground and hear the sentence of your moved prince. If you ever disturb our streets again, your lives shall pay the forfeit of the peace.
My lord, what say you to my suit?
The child is yet a stranger in this world. Let 2 summers wither, ere we may think her ripe to be a bride. This night I hold an old accustomed feast. Go, sirrah, through fair Verona, find those persons, and to them say my house and welcome on their pleasure stay.
My master is the great rich Capulet, and if you be not of the house of Montagues, I pray come and crush a cup of wine. Rest you merry.
At the same ancient feast of Capulet sups the fair Rosaline whom thou so loves.
I'll go along, no such sight to be shown, but to rejoice in splendor of mine own.
Nurse, where's my daughter? Call her forth to me.
Now by my maidenhead, at 12 year old I bade her come. What lamb? What ladybird? Oh, God forbid, where is this girl? What? Juliet!
Madame, I am here. What is your will?
Nurse, give leave a while. We must talk in secret. Nurse, come back again. I have remembered me. Thou wast here our counsel. Thou knowest my daughter's of a pretty age.
Faith, I can tell her age on to an hour.
Enough of this. I pray thee. Hold thy peace. Tell me, daughter, Juliet, how stands your disposition to be married?
It is an honor I dream not of.
Speak briefly. Can you like of Paris's love?
I'll look to like it, looking liking move, but no more deep will I in dart mine eye than your consent gives strength to make it fly.
Madam, the guests are come.
We follow thee.
Give me a torch, I'm not for this ambling. Being but heavy, I will bear the light.
Nay, gentle Romeo, we must have you dance.
Not I, believe me. You have dancing shoes with nimble soles. I have a soul of lead, so stakes me to the ground, I cannot move.
You are a lover. Borrow Cupid's wings, and soar with them above a common bound. If love be rough with you, be rough with love.
Welcome, gentlemen, ladies that have their toes. Come, musicians, play.
What lady is that, which doth enrich the hand of yonder knight? Did my heart love till now? Forswear its sight, for I ne'er saw true beauty till this night.
Uncle, this is a Montague, our foe, a villain that has come hither in spite.
Young Romeo, is it?
Tis he, that villain Romeo.
Content thee, gentle cuz. Let him alone.
I'll not endure him.
Oh, you are a saucy boy. Be quiet, or he'll make you quiet.
I will withdraw. But this intrusion shall now seeming sweet convert to bitter gall.
If I profane with my unworthiest hand this holy shrine, the gentle fine is this, my lips to blushing pilgrims to smooth that rough touch with a tender kiss.
Good pilgrim, you do wrong your hand too much, for saints have hands that pilgrims' hands do touch, and palm to palm is holy palmer's kiss.
Have not saints' lips and holy palmers too?
Aye, pilgrim, lips that they must use in prayer.
Oh, well then, dear saint, let us lips do what hands do. They pray, grant thou, lest faith turn to despair.
Saints do not move, though grant, for prayer's sake.
Then move not, while my prayer's effect I take. Thus from my lips by yours my sin is purged.
Then have my lips the sin that they have took?
Sin from thy lips. Give me my sin again.
Madam, your mother craves a word with you.
Is she a Capulet? Oh, dear count, my life is my foe's debt.
I thank you, honest gentleman. Good night. Come on, then. Let's to bed.
Come hither, nurse. What is yon gentleman?
His name is Romeo, and a Montague, the only son of your great enemy.
Oh, my only love sprung from my only hate. Too early seen, unknown, known too late. Oh, Romeo, Romeo! Wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name, or if thou wilt not be but sworn my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet.
Call me but love, and I'll be new baptized. Henceforth I never will be Romeo.
How camest thou hither? The orchard walls are high and hard to climb.
But love's light wings did e'er perch these walls, for stony limits cannot hold love out.
Dost thou love me? Oh, gentle Romeo, if thou dost love, pronounce it faithfully.
Lady, by yonder blessed moon, I vow.
Oh, swear not by the moon, the inconstant moon.
What shall I swear by?
Do not swear at all, or, if thou wilt, swear by thy gracious self. Good night, as sweet repose and rest come to thy heart, is that within my breast.
Oh, wilt thou leave me so unsatisfied?
What satisfaction canst thou have tonight?
The exchange of thy love's faithful vow for mine.
I gave thee mine before thou didst request it, and yet I would it were to give again.
Wouldst thou withdraw it? For what purpose, love?
But to be frank, and give it thee again.
Juliet!
Dear love, adieu. Sweet Montague, be true.
Oh, blessed, blessed night.
Three words, dear Romeo. Thy purpose, marriage. Send word tomorrow.
Madam!
Romeo!
My dear.
At 1 o'clock tomorrow shall I send to thee?
At the hour of 9.
I will not fail. Parting is such sweet sorrow. We shall say good night till it be morrow.
Tomorrow, father.
Our Romeo hath not been in bed tonight.
The sweeter rest was mine.
God pardon sin. Was that with Rosalind?
With Rosalind, my ghostly father. No, I forgot that name. That name's woe.
That's my good son. But where hast thou been then?
Well, then know my heart's dear love is set on the fair daughter of rich Capulet. We met, we wooed, and made exchange of vow, but this I pray, that thou consent to marry us today.
In one respect I'll thy assistant be, for this alliance may so happy prove, to turn your household rancor to pure love.
Bid her devise some means to come to shrift this afternoon, and there she shall at Friar Lawrence's cell be shrived and married. Here's for thy pains.
No, truly, sir, not a penny.
Go to, I say you shall.
This afternoon, sir? Well, she shall be there.
We will make short work, For, by your leaves, you shall not stay alone till Holy Church incorporate two in one.
I pray thee, good Mercutio. Let's retire. The day is hot, the Capulet's abroad, and if we meet, we shall not scape a brawl.
Thy head is as full of quarrels as an egg is full of meat, and yet thou wilt tutor me from quarreling.
By my head, here come the Capulets.
By my heel, I care not.
Mercutio, thou consortest with Romeo.
Consort? What, dost thou make us minstrels?
Either withdraw unto some private place, or reason coldly of your grievances, or else depart.
Here comes my man. Romeo, the hate I bear thee can afford no better term than this. Thou art a villain.
Such a grating villain I am none. Therefore, farewell. I see thou knowest me not.
Boy, this shall not excuse the injuries that thou hast done me. Therefore, turn and draw.
I do protest I never injured thee, but love thee better than thou canst devise, till thou shalt know the reason of my love. And so, good Capulet, whose name I tender as dearly as mine own, be satisfied. Oh, calm, dishonorable, vile submission! Tybalt, will you walk?
I am for you.
Help me into some house, Benvolio.
What? Art thou hurt?
Aye, a scratch. Mary, 'tis enough. Help me into some house, Benvolio, or I shall faint. A plague of both your houses. They have made worm's meat of me, I have it, and soundly too. Your houses!
Oh, Romeo. Romeo, brave Mercutio is dead.
Alive in triumph, and Mercutio slain. Fire-eyed fury be my conduct now. Now, Tybalt, take the villain back again that late thou gavest me, for Mercutio's soul's but a little way above our heads, staying for thine to keep him company. Either thou or I or both must go with him.
Thou, wretched boy, that didst consort him here, shall with him hence.
This shall determine that.
Romeo, away, be gone. The prince will doom thee death.
Where are the vile beginners of this fray?
There lies the man slain by young Romeo that slew thy kinsman, brave Mercutio.
For blood of ours, shed blood of Montague, Romeo must not live.
Not Romeo, prince. He was Mercutio's friend. His fault concludes but what the law should end, the life of Tybalt.
And for that offense, immediately we do exile him hence.
Things have fallen out, sir, that we have had no time to move our daughter.
Madam, commend me to your daughter.
I will. Marry my child, early next Thursday morn, the Count de Paris.
I will not marry yet, and when I do, it shall be Romeo, rather than Paris.
What is this? Out, you green sickness carrion, out, you baggage, you tallow face.
Good father, I beseech you on my knees, hear me with patience, but to speak a word.
Get thee to a church, O Thursday, or never look me again in the face.
Oh, bid me leap rather than marry Paris, and I will do it without fear or doubt.
Take thou this vial, this distilled liquor drink thou off, when presently through all thy veins shall run a cold and drowsy humor, for no pulse shall keep his native progress, appear like death. And in this borrowed likeness of shrunk death, thou shalt continue for 240 hours, and then awake as from a pleasant sleep. When the bridegroom comes to rouse thee from thy bed, there art thou dead. Shall Romeo by my letters know our drift?
Give me, oh, tell me not of fear. Romeo, here is drink. I drink to thee.
News from Verona. How now, Balthazar? How fares my Juliet?
Her body sleeps in Capel's monument. I saw her laid low in her kindred's vault.
Is it even so? Then I defy you, stars! Hire a post horses, I will hence tonight!
I do beseech you, sir, have patience. Your looks are pale and wild.
Hush, thou art deceived. Hast thou no letters to me from the friar?
No, my good lord.
Come, cordial, not poison, go with me to Juliet's grave. For there I must use thee.
Sweet flower, with flowers thy bridal bed I strew. Oh, woe! What cursed foot wanders this way tonight to cross my obsequies and true love's rite? Condemned villain, I do apprehend thee, for thou must die.
Will thou provoke me? Then have at thee, boy! My love, my wife, oh, dear Juliet. Here's to my love. Oh, a true apothecary, that drugs are quick. Thus, with a kiss, I die.
What's here? A cup closed in my true love's hand? Oh, happy dagger. This is thy sheath and there thy rust. And let me die. Oh.
Oh, heavens, oh, wife, look how our daughter bleeds.
I will be brief. Romeo, there dead, was husband to that Jew. I married them in their stolen marriage day, was Tybalt's doomsday, whose death banished the new-made bridegroom from the city. Then gave I her a sleeping potion, for it wrought on her the form of death. Meantime, I writ to Romeo, but he which bore my letter was stayed by accident.
Where be these enemies? Capulet, Montague, see a scourge is laid upon your hate.
Oh, brother Montague, give me thy hand. This is my daughter's jointure.
There shall no figure at such rate be set as that of true and faithful Juliet.
A glooming peace this morning with it brings, for never was a story of more woe than this of Juliet and her Romeo.
Hey, Juliet, I say, you're fine, you really blow my mind. Baby, someday, you make it run away. I just want you to know, I wanna be your Romeo. Hey, Juliet, hey, Juliet. Hey, Juliet.
Which of you, shall we say, doth love us most, that we our largest bounty may extend, where nature doth with merit challenge? Goneril, our eldest born, speak first.
Sir, I do love you more than words can wield the matter, dearer than eyesight, space, and liberty. Beyond all manner of so much, I love you.
What says our second daughter, our dearest Regan, wife to Cornwall? Speak.
Sir, I am made of the selfsame metal that my sister is, and prize me at her worth. Find I am alone, felicitate in your dear highness's love.
To thee and thine hereditary ever remain this ample third of our fair kingdom. No less space, validity, and pleasure than that conferred on Goneril. Now, our joy, strive to be interest. What can you say to draw a third more opulent than your sister's? Speak.
Nothing, my lord.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing can come of nothing. Speak again.
I love your majesty according to my bond. No more nor less.
Thy dowerless dull-tail king, thrown to my chance, is queen of us, of ours, and our fair France.
Thou hast her, France. Here I disclaim all the parental care, and as a stranger to my heart and me, hold thee from this forever. Therefore, be gone, without our grace, our love, our benison.
Time shall unfold what plighted cunning hides. Who covers faults at last, shame them derides. Well may you prosper.
Why brand they us with base? With baseness, with bastardy, base, base. Who in the lusty stealth of nature take more composition and fierce quality than doth with a dull bed? Well then, legitimate Edgar, I must have your land. Edmund the base shall top the legitimate. Now, gods, stand up for bastards.
Why so earnestly seek you to put up that letter? Give me the letter, sir.
I hope my brother wrote this as an essay or taste of my virtue.
The custom of respecting elderly keeps us without our inheritance until we are so old we can't enjoy our happiness. Come to me that of this may I speak more. Edgar. Oh, villain, villain, where is he?
Let me, if not by birth, have lands by wit.
I'll not endure it. His knights grow riotous, and himself upbraids us on every trifle. When he returns from hunting, I will not speak with him. Say I am sick. Idle old man that still would manage those he hath given away.
Very well, madame.
How now, daughter? Methinks you are too much of late in the frown.
Here do you keep 100 knights so disordered that this our court shows like a riotous inn. Be then desired by her to disquantity your train.
Bastard, thou liest! My train are men of rarest parts. I have another daughter who, when she hears this, with her nails she'll flay thy wolfish visage. Away, away!
Oh, sir, fly you this place. And cunning, I must draw my sword upon you. Seem to defend yourself. Now quit you well. Yield! Come before my father. Light, ho! Look, sir, I bleed.
Oh, strange and fastened villain. Would he deny his letter? Let him fly far. And of my land, loyal boy, I'll work the means to make thee capable.
How now, my noble friend? I have heard strange news.
My old heart is cracked. It's cracked.
What? Did my father's godson seek your life? He whom my father named your Edgar?
Shame would have it hid.
If he be taken, he shall never more be feared of doing harm.
Our father he hath, which so hath our sister. Our old good friend, lay comforts to your bosom and bestow your needful counsel to our business.
I serve you, madam. Your graces are right welcome.
While I may escape, I will preserve myself, and am besought to take the basest shape that every punery and contempt of man brought near to beast. Poor Tom, that is something yet. Edgar, I nothing am.
Beloved Regan, thy sister's not, she hath tied on kindness here.
Oh, sir, you are old, therefore I pray you say you have wronged her, sir.
Art not ashamed? Oh, Regan, wilt thou take her by hand?
You will return and sojourn with my sister.
Persuade me rather to be slave to this detested groom.
At your choice, sir.
Let us withdraw. 'Twill be a storm.
Blow, winds, and crack your cheeks. Rage, blow! Strike flat the thick rotundity of the world. Crack nature's molds that make ingrateful man.
I have received a letter this night. These injuries the king now bears will be revenged as part of a power already footed. We must incline to the king. If I die for it, as no less has threatened me, the king, my old master, must be relieved.
This courtesy, forbid thee, shall the Duke instantly know. And of that letter, too. This must draw me all that which my father loses, no less than all. The younger rises when the old doth fall. Malicious is my fortune that I repent to be just.
Seek out where thy father is.
I'll preserve in my course of loyalty.
I will lay trust upon thee, and thou shalt find a dearer father in my love. The army of France is landed. Seek out the traitor Gloucester.
Ingrateful fox, 'tis he.
Bind fast his corky arms.
I shall see the winged vengeance overtake such children.
Seat shalt thou never. Upon these eyes of thine I'll set my foot.
Oh, cruelly, God!
Hold out your hand, my lord! Give me your sword!
I am slain! My lord, you have one eye left to see some mischief on him!
Let to see more, prevent it. Out, vile jelly!
Where is my son, Edward?
Out, treacherous villain! Thou callest on him that hates thee. It was he that made the overture of thy treasons to us.
Oh, my follies! That Edgar was abused. Kind gods prosper him.
Go thrust him out the gates. Let him smell his way back to Dover.
I have received a hurt. Follow me, lady.
Yet better thus, and known to be contemned, than still contemned and flattered. Who comes here? My father, poorly led? Poor Tom shall lead thee.
I marvel our mild husband not met us on the way. Where's your master?
The madam within, but never man so changed, of Gloucester's treachery, and of the royal service of his son, when I informed him, he called me sought. And told me I had turned the wrong side out. What like offensive?
This kiss would stretch thy spirits up into the air.
Yours in the ranks of death.
I have been worth the whistle.
Oh, Goneril, I fear your disposition.
Oh, my good lord, the Duke of Cornwall's dead, slain by his servant, going to put out the other eye of Gloucester.
Oh, poor Gloucester, I live to thank thee for the love thou showedst the king, and to revenge thine eye.
It was great ignorance, Gloucester's eyes being out, to let him live. Edwin is gone to dispatch his knighted life.
I must seize after him with my letter. My lady charged my duty in this business.
Why should she write to Edmund? She gave most speaking looks to noble Edmund. Take this note. My lord is dead, and more convenient is he for my hand than for your lady's. So, fare you well.
News, madam. The British powers are marching hitherward.
It's known before. Our preparation stands in expectation of them. No blown ambition doth our arms incite. Love, dear love, and our aged father's right.
Look, look, a mouse. Peace, peace, this piece of toasted cheese will do it.
I know that voice. It's not the king.
I am a king. Know you that? Come, you shall get it by running. Saw, 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 saw.
A proclaimed prize, thou traitor. The sword is out that must destroy thee.
Thou let thy friendly hand put strength enough to it.
No matter. Vor your foins.
Thou hast freed me. Give the letter which thou findest about me to Edmund, Earl of Gloucester.
What, is he dead?
Sit you down, father, rest you. Let our reciprocal vows be remembered. You have many opportunities to cut him off. Your wife, so I would say, Goneril. Oh, indistinguished space of woman's will.
You are a spirit, I know. Where did you die?
Oh, look upon me, sir, and hold your hands in benediction, army.
Do not laugh at me, for I think this lady to be my child, Cordelia.
And so I am. I am.
Sweet lord, you know the goodness I attend upon you. Tell me but truly, do you not love my sister?
An honored love.
I shall never endure her. Be not familiar with her.
Fear me not. She and the Duke, her husband.
I had rather lose the battle than that sister should loosen him and me. King is come to his daughter with others whom rigor of our state forced to cry out. For this, France invades our land. Combine together against the enemy.
Hear me one word.
Speak.
Before you fight the battle, open this letter.
The enemy's in view. Drop your powers.
Away! King Lear hath lost. He and his daughter taken. Rightness is all. Come on.
We are not the first who, with best meaning, have incurred the worst. For thee, oppressed king, I am cast down.
Take them away. Sir, I thought it fit to send the old and miserable king to some retention.
General, I create thee here my lord and master.
Mean you to enjoy him? The let alone lies not in your goodwill.
Nor in thine, lord.
Edmund, I arrest thee on capital treason.
For your claim, Bear Sister, I bar in the interest of my wife. 'Tis she is subcontracted to this lord, and I, her husband, contradict your bans. My lady is bespoke.
What in the world that names me traitor? Villain like he lies.
My sickness grows upon me.
What's he that speaks for Edmund, Earl of Gloucester?
Himself.
Your mouth, dame, or with this paper shall I stop it.
What art thou?
My name is Edgar, and thy father's son. Our lives' sweetness taught me to shift into a madman's rags. I met my father with his bleeding rings, saved him from despair. I never revealed myself unto him until some half hour passed. Blessing. His broad heart twixt extremes of joy and grief burst smiling.
Your lady, sir, and her sister by hers poisoned, she confesses it.
I was contracted to them both. All three now marry in an instant. Some good I mean to do despite of mine own nature. Quickly send to the castle, for my writ is on the life of Lear and Cordelia. Nay, send in time.
A plague upon you. Murderers! Traitors all! I might have saved her.
Edmund is dead, my lord.
No, no life. Oh, thou'lt come no more, never, never. Pray you. Do you see this? Look on her. Look her lips. Look there. Look there. Oh. Oh.
He faints, my lord. Look up, my lord. Oh. He is gone indeed.
Rule in this realm. And the gored state sustained.
The weight of this sad time, we must obey. Speak what we feel, not what we ought to say. Hence, is this a holiday? Speak, what trade art thou?
A mender of bad souls.
But wherefore art not in thy shop today? Why dost thou lead these men about the streets?
We make holiday, to see Caesar and to rejoice in his triumph.
Wherefore rejoice? What conquests bring he home? You blocks, you stones, you worse than senseless things, be gone!
Let no images be hung with Caesar's trophies. These growing feathers plucked from Caesar's wing will make him fly an ordinary pitch. Who else would soar above the view of men and keep us all in servile fearfulness?
Caesar, beware the eyes of March.
I do fear the people choose Caesar for their king.
I do you fear it. Then must I think you would not have it so.
I would not, Cassius, yet I love him well.
What should be in that Caesar?
What you have said I will consider. Brutus had rather be a villager than to repute himself a son of Rome under these hard conditions.
Antonius, yon Cassius has a lean and hungry look.
Fear him not, Caesar. It's a noble Roman, well given.
Would he were fatter, but I fear him not.
Casca, tell us what hath chanced today that Caesar looks so sad.
There was a crown offered him. He would fain have had it.
Who offered him the crown?
Why, Antony.
Well, Brutus, thou art noble, yet I see thy honorable metal may be for wrought, for so firm that can be seduced.
They say the senators tomorrow mean to establish Caesar as a king.
I know he would not be a wolf, but that he sees the Romans are but sheep. I know where I will wear this dagger then. Cassius from bondage will deliver Cassius.
So will I. Hold my hand.
It must be by his death. And for my part, I know no personal cause to spurn at him, but for the general. He would be crowned. How that might change his nature, there's the question. It is the bright day that brings forth the adder. Therefore, think him as a serpent's egg, which hatched, would as his kind grow mischievous, and kill him in the shell.
I found this paper, thus sealed up, and I'm sure it did not lie there when I went to bed.
Get you to bed again. It is not day. Is not tomorrow, boy, the Ides of March? Brutus, thou sleepst. Awake and see thyself. Speak, strike, redress. Somebody knocks.
Good morrow, Brutus. Do we trouble you?
I have been up this hour, awake all night. Know I these men that come along with you?
Yes, every man of them, and no man here but honors you.
Give me your hands all over, one by one.
Shall no man else be touched but only Caesar?
I think it is not meet Antony, so well beloved of Caesar, should outlive Caesar.
Let's be sacrificers, but not butchers, Cassius. And for Antony, think not of him.
Friends, disperse yourselves, but all remember what you have said and show yourselves true Romans.
You have ungently, Brutus, stole from my bed.
I am not well in health, and that is all.
No, my Brutus, you have some sick offense within your mind, which, by the right and virtue of my place, should I know of.
You are my true and honorable wife, as dear to me as are the ruddy drops that visit my sad heart.
If this were true, then should I know this secret. I have made strong proof of my constancy, giving myself a voluntary wound here, in the thigh. Can I bear that with patience and not my husband's secrets?
Hark, hark, one knocks. Portia, go in a while, and by thy bosom shall partake the secrets of my heart.
Brave son, derived from honorable loins, thou like an exorcist, has conjured up my mortified spirit. What's to do?
A piece of work that will make sick men whole.
But aren't we not some whole that must make sick?
That must we also. What is it, my Caius? I shall unfold to thee, as we are going to whom it must be done. Follow me.
Those predictions are to the world in general as to Caesar. Cowards die many times before their deaths. The valiant never taste of death but once.
Caesar, all hail.
Decius, bear my greetings to the senators and tell them that I will not come today. Calphurnia, my wife stays me at home. She dreamt tonight she saw my statue, which, like a fountain with 100 spouts, did run pure blood. And many lusty Romans came smiling and did bathe their hands in it.
This dream is all a misinterpreted. It was a vision, fair and fortunate, that from you, great Rome, shall suck reviving blood. And know it now, the Senate have concluded to give this day a crown to mighty Caesar. If you shall send them word you will not come, their minds may be changed.
How foolish do your fears seem now, Calphurnia? I will go. The Ides of March are come.
Great Caesar, but not gone.
I kiss thy hand, but not in flattery, Caesar.
What, Brutus?
Oh, Caesar.
Doth not Brutus bootless kneel?
Speak hands for me.
Et tu, Brute.
Liberty, freedom, tyranny is dead. Run hence, proclaim, cried about the streets.
Fly not, stand stiff. Ambition's debt is paid. Stoop, Romans, stoop. And let us bathe our hands in Caesar's blood. Then walk we forth.
So often shall the knot of us be called the men that gave their country liberty.
Oh, mighty Caesar! I know not, gentlemen, what you intend, who else must be let blood. If I myself, there is no hour so fit as Caesar's death hour.
Oh, Antony, beg not your death of us. Only be patient till we have appeased the multitude, and then we will deliver you the cause why I, that did love Caesar when I struck him, have thus proceeded.
I doubt not of your wisdom. Let each man render me his bloody hand.
Our reasons are so full of good regard. You should be satisfied.
That's all I seek, and am, moreover, suitor that I may produce his body to the marketplace, and as he becomes a friend, speak in the order of his funeral.
You shall, Antony.
You know not what you do. Know you how much the people may be moved by that which he will utter?
I roll myself into the pulpit first, and show the reason of our Caesar's death.
I know not what may fall. I like it not.
Antony, take you Caesar's body. You shall not in your funeral speech blame us, but speak all good you can devise of Caesar, and say do it by our permission, else you shall not have any hand at all about his funeral.
Be it so. Oh, pardon me, thou bleeding piece of earth, that I am meek and gentle with these butchers. Woe to the hand that shed this costly blood. Fierce civil strife shall cumber all the parts of Italy. Caesar's spirit shall in these confines cry havoc, and let slip the dogs of war that this foul deed shall smell above the earth.
Romans, hear me for my cause. As Caesar loved me, I weep for him. As he was valiant, I honor him. But as he was ambitious, I slew him. Who is here so rude that would not be a Roman? If any speak for him, I have offended.
None, Brutus.
None, Brutus. None.
I have done no more to Caesar than you shall do to Brutus. I have the same dagger for myself when it shall please my country to need my death.
Live!
Live, Brutus! Live!
Let me depart alone, and for my sake, stay here with Antony. I do entreat you, not a man depart save I alone, till Antony have spoke.
Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. He was my friend, faithful and just to me. But Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. You all did see I thrice presented him a kingly crown, which he did thrice refuse. Was this ambition? Look. In this place ran Cassius's dagger through. Through this, the well-beloved Brutus stabbed. Brutus, as you know, was Caesar's angel. This was the unkindest cut of all.
Oh, traitors, villain!
Great friends, let me not stir you up to such a sudden flood of mutiny.
We'll mutiny.
We'll burn the house of Brutus.
Away then, come, seek the conspirators.
Mischief, thou art afoot. Take thou what course thou wilt.
Sir, Octavius has already come. I heard him say Brutus and Cassius are rid like madmen through the gates of Rome.
Like they had some notice of the people, how I had moved them. Bring me to Octavius.
Oh, Cassius, I am sick of many griefs. Portia is dead.
Oh, insupportable and touching loss. Upon what sickness?
Impatience of my absence, and grief that young Octavius with Mark Antony have made themselves so strong. For with her death that tidings came. With this she fell distract, and her attendants absent, swallowed fire.
Oh, ye immortal gods.
No more of her. Octavius and Mark Antony come down upon us with a mighty power. Words before blows, countrymen.
Oh, you flatterers.
Come, Antony, away. Traitors, if you dare fight today, come to the field. If not, when you have stomach.
Now, most noble Brutus, if we lose this battle, are you contented to be led in triumph through the streets of Rome?
No, Cassius, no. But this same day must end that work the Ides of March begun. Forever and forever, farewell, Cassius. If we do meet again, why, we shall smile. If not, why then this parting was well made.
Oh, my lord, Titinius is enclosed round about. He's taken.
Behold no more. Here, take thou the hilts and guide thy sword. Caesar, thou art revenged, even with the sword that killed thee.
Where did you leave him?
With Pindarus on this hill.
Is that not he?
No, this was he, Messala, but Cassius is no more. Mistrust of my success hath done this deed.
Oh, hateful heir, why dost thou show the apt thoughts of men the things that are not?
Where art thou, Pindarus?
Seek him, Titinius, while I go to meet the noble Brutus.
Alas, thou hast misconstrued everything. By your leave, gods, this is a Roman's part. Come, Cassius' sword, and find Titinius's heart.
Where doth his body lie?
Yonder, and Titinius is mourning it.
He is slain!
Oh, Julius Caesar, thou art mighty yet. The last of all the Romans, fare thee well. Friends, I owe more tears to this dead man than you shall see me pay. I shall find time, Cassius. I shall find time.
I am Brutus. Kill Brutus and be honored in his death.
This is not Brutus, friend, but I assure you a prize no less than worth. Keep this man safe. I'd rather have such men my friends than enemies.
I shall have glory by this losing day more than Octavius and Antony. Night hangs upon my eyes. My bones would rest that have but labored to attain this hour. Caesar, now be still. I killed not thee with half so good a will.
Strato, where is thy master?
Free from the bondage you are in, Messala, for Brutus only overcame himself, and no man else hath honor by his death. This was the noblest Roman of them all. All the conspirators, save only he, did that they did in envy of great Caesar. He only, in a general honest thought and common good to all, made one of them. His life was gentle, and the elements so mixed in him that nature might stand up and say to all the world, this was a man.
According to his virtue, let us use him with all the respects and rites of burial.
Makes my heart beat fast. I've tried to page you twice, but I see you roll your eyes.